So another way to think about the biblical understanding of blessings would be to say this, and this is the phrase that will carry us through this whole sermon series. Blessings are tangible goods given by God to the undeserving to be shared with the unwitting. And we see here several keys that went through Abraham's mind that allowed him to be a blessing. And we see three key family traits that God wants for his people. And what makes these three keys, these three family traits really pop out, and while we know they're not just Abraham acting on his own, but we know these are family traits, is we see the same three key traits in Jesus too. First, Abraham interceded for others. Second, Abraham extended himself. Third and finally, Abraham advocated for the undeserving. This is how the church flourished. They didn't worry about who was right, who was wrong, who was deserving, who was undeserving, who was moral, who was just. They didn't worry about that. They concerned themselves with being a blessing to everyone. Because the truth is we are all undeserving. The truth is there is a beast in all of us. And this is actually so very freeing. This should be incredibly freeing to us because we don't need to worry about who deserves to be blessed. We don't need to worry about, well, who is worthy. We just do it. We are set free from the crushing weight of discerning someone's heart and whether or not they deserve it. Because the truth is, none of us do. Not one of us. But Jesus blesses us anyway.